What's up, guys? Today I am doing something totally new, kinda. It's still reactions, but yeah. We are going to watch a scary animation story. I know you guys love them and you've asked for them, and finally, I'm doing them. This is a hitchhiker horror story. It's super cool and creepy. You're gonna love it. But before we get started, don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram. Links are all down below. And give this video a like and a share. But yeah, again, this animation is called The Hitchhiking Horror Story. It's from a channel called Thriller Teller, and I have the link to this video in the description below as well as her channel. So you can go check out this one and the rest of her animations. All the links are in the description below. Go check it out. But yeah, I think we're ready to get spooky, guys. So grab your stuffed animals. Kitty, I want this one today. Grab your stuffed animals, your blanket, and your candles. Turn the lights off and let's go. Thriller Teller. Hitchhiking Horror Story. Move the mouse.
Andrea and Ryan were very close friends who used to spend a lot of time together.
Okay, first off, why is this dude wearing a polo? You going to private school or something? He's already spooky. Like, look at his eyes. He's scaring me. Anyways, sorry, let's continue.
But for the past couple of weeks, Ryan did not contact or respond to any of his messages. And due to virus lockdown, Andrea couldn't visit him.
Oh, this is because of the virus.
He was worried for his friend's safety. Then suddenly, one day, he received a call from Ryan. Hello, Ryan. What happened? Is everything okay?
What's wrong, Ryan?
Yeah, everything is fine. I don't believe this. I can tell something is up with you. You haven't been replying to any of my messages or calls.
Mm-hmm.
So you know how I usually finish my shift at Tesco around 6 in the evening? Yeah? Now, due to virus lockdown, I was put on an evening shift schedule by my manager.
Oh, heck no.
A few days ago, when I was driving back home, after my shift around midnight, something really weird happened.
What was it? Okay, don't drive through the forest.
What is she doing here at this hour?
Who the heck was
that? Around.
Okay, what kind of woman just chills in the forest? You don't stop for a random lady just chilling in a dark, spooky forest. Come on, guys, common sense.
Hi, I've recently started working at the nearby hospital. Due to lockdown, I haven't been able to arrange a car share yet. Do you mind giving me a lift to the nearest subway station?
No.
She was wearing a clinical mask on her face, and there was something about her soul-piercing eyes that I couldn't say no to her. Yeah, sure, no problem.
I don't like her.
Oh, thank you so much for the ride. By the way, my name is Natalie. Well, hi, Natalie.
He actually gave her a ride.
Do you usually finish work this late? No, I usually finish around 6. I work at Tesco's, but due to lockdown, my manager put me on evening shifts for a few weeks.
Don't tell her anything.
I was actually surprised when I saw you. Usually the road is so quiet around this time. I've never seen anyone. Really? So how are you finding your new job?
That was creepy.
It must be chaotic in the hospital around this time. Taking care of so many safety measurements. Yeah. So what do you do? Are you a nurse? Oh, thank you. Just stop here, please.
I hate people who answer with one word in a conversation like, okay, I get it, you don't like me.
Walk to the station from here. Thanks again for the ride. She didn't reply to my question and left as if she was in a hurry. There was something mysterious
to go kill someone
which left me wanting to know her more. And her eyes, those eyes were...
So her one word replies made you interested and you want to keep picking her up in the middle of the woods? Yeah, that's not creepy.
Rising made me want to see what she looked like.
Her eyes are brown.
Then
What's so interesting?
Happened? Was she there the next night? Yes, she was. Waiting for me at the same spot.
He kept picking her up.
I stopped my car near her, like I was under her spell. She got in, and I drove off.
A spell?
We chatted the whole way, laughed, and I was starting to enjoy her company and looked forward to seeing her again. There was so much I wanted to know about her.
She's a witch.
But she would always dodge any personal questions.
But yeah, she's a killer.
All I wanted was her company.
Get a cat.
On and on for days. and I felt myself drawn closer and closer to her every day. I was getting more and more curious and couldn't wait to see what she looked like.
I bet you she's a witch.
She wasn't there. I stopped my car at her usual spot.
Cause she's killing someone.
She didn't mention that she would be off today. I hope she's okay. Then I heard a distant laugh behind the trees.
She's with someone else.
Huh? I started walking in the same direction. There, I saw her. I saw Natalie holding hands with another man.
Oh, this girl is a player. I bet she does this with anyone who drives on the road. Like every other night, it's a new dude. This dude's hurt. He's jealous. Like, really? You getting picked up by another stranger? That's not cool.
And chatting. Don't know why, but it made me kind of upset.
Ugh. That's an ugly face.
They both went behind a large tree. I can't wait any longer. You're driving me crazy. I want to see what you look like.
Why?
It's time.
For what? Oh, heck no!
Natalie tore out the man's throat right in front of my eyes. She was scarfing down this man like he was a piece of delicious meat.
Oh, I hate that noise!
Her face was the most terrifying thing I'd ever seen.
Go away!
I ran back to my car in horror.
You better run, boy!
As fast as I could.
This girl just ripped out a man's throat like some vampire. Dude, that sound, the chomping, it was just like...
That's insane. I was so traumatized that I couldn't go to work the next few days. My mind couldn't process what happened. Did you call the police? Yeah, and tell what? That I saw a demon munching on a human? Do you think
Dummy.
They would believe me? But obviously,
I'd believe
stay
you.
Home for long. You know I can't afford to lose this job. So yesterday I went back to work. And did you see her again? Yes, I did. I drove past her as fast as I could, pretending.
Okay, now you're smart. But she knows.
Take my advice. Do not, and I repeat, do not drive on that road again. You're lucky that you're alive.
Seriously.
It could have been you instead of that man. I know. I've already talked to my manager that I can't do these evening shifts anymore. He's promised me that he's gonna put me back on my regular schedule from next week.
Good.
Ugh, that's a relief. But please be very careful until then. I will.
This dummy went back for her. Freaking idiot probably died. Ryan's dead body was found in his car a few days later, his throat torn out. Oh my God, this dummy went back for her and died even after he saw her eating some guy like a shark. You know what, that's his own fault. I don't feel bad, I'm sorry. I'm a terrible person, but he literally saw her eat a man and he still went back for her. Well, he did say he was under like a spell, whatever, but dang, he did. That sucks. Anyways, hope you guys like the scary animations. That wasn't too creepy. Next time we'll do one that's a little scarier. But yeah, hope you liked it. Again, you can watch this animation on a channel called Thriller Teller. I have the links all down below. So please go check it out. But yeah, that was spooky. I really loved it though. I honestly did. That was a good story. So comment below if you liked it. And again, don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram. Links are all down below. And give this video a like and a share, please. And I will see you creepy people next time.